We would like to thank our community partners, Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty, Myers Financial, Body Best Collision Center, Krista Granton Insurance, and Marbray Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice. Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
Good evening, folks, and welcome to this broadcast of Sonoma Stompers Baseball on SVTV 27 Comcast Cable. We are also online live on Ustream.tv. Thanks to SVTV27.com. It is one heck of a historic night here again as the first all-female battery in the history of men's professional baseball will happen in just a few minutes as the Sonoma Stompers host the Pittsburgh Diamonds. My name is Tim Livingston. 3 weeks ago tonight, it was one of the coolest scenes that you'll see in the history of baseball. Two women started. It was Stacy Piagno on the hill and Kelsie Whitmore in left field. Since then, the two women have gotten their opportunities to play with the Stompers on a regular basis. After Kelsie Whitmore left the team for a little bit of time, she came back this past Wednesday and got herself her first professional hit against the San Rafael Pacifics. Stacy Piagno has appeared in four games and in her most recent appearance out of the bullpen last night, two innings of shutout baseball. Tonight, a third woman joins the team in U.S. Women's National Team star catcher Anna Kimbrell, who was with the U.S. Women's National Team from the age of 17. And she has won five medals with the team, including a gold last year at the Pan Am Games. And she is here tonight to be the catcher in this all-female battery. And it will be Kelsie Whitmore getting the start in her first pitching appearance with the Stompers in 2016. This is something that the Stompers have been kind of building up to since this nine-month kind of roller coaster ride began with Francis Ford Coppola giving the idea of giving the Stompers the platform to assimilate women into professional baseball, giving them the opportunity to play, advance them, really not just bring them in for a day or two, but giving them an opportunity to work out with the team and improve their skills. And the Stompers are very happy with, of course, what Kelsie Whitmore has done and with Stacy Piagno. And now tonight, Anna Kimbrell, who has caught both Piagno and Whitmore before. She was the catcher in Piagno's no-hitter last year in the Pan Am Games against Puerto Rico. She will be catching Whitmore tonight. Whitmore actually did well in the Pan Am Games herself in her five innings, a 1.40 earned run average. And so Whitmore, who had played mainly in the field, in left field to be precise, will actually be the person on the mound tonight. And so it'll be pretty fun to see this happen. It's just the next step in this phenomenal journey that began beginning of this month when the Stompers gave women the opportunity to play baseball right alongside the men. And the two women who have done it so far have really proved themselves and then some. And now tonight it's Anna Kimbrell's turn. So we are so happy you're with us tonight. We're just a few minutes away from getting started here at People's Home Equity Ballpark in Sonoma. The Stompers as a whole are on a little bit of a skid. They lost all three games against the Pacifics earlier this week, being swept for the first time in 2016. Last night, a 7-2 loss here in Sonoma. But the Stompers are very happy that of their final 33 games, 20 will be played here at People's Home Equity Ballpark, and they get to play the Pacifics 15 more times. The Pacifics have been on a roll. They've won six straight, and they are looking to do what they did last year, which was win the second half and put it into a one-game playoff for the Pacific Association Championship. But the Stompers, they don't want that to happen. They're playing for a second-half title so they can win it outright. And so the Stompers in this game tonight against the Pittsburg Diamonds, who have made a few personnel changes of their own. They saw one of their best players in Brian Gwynn, the former Padres farmhand, move up to Sioux Falls of the American Association. So they have a couple of new faces in the lineup tonight. And it'll be interesting to see as both teams really try and make that battle happen. As you can see, Takashi Miyoshi there speaking with Aaron Miles, the manager of both teams tonight, talking it over. The big question on everybody's mind is who is going to be there in the second half? Is it going to be the Stompers making a repeat of it? Is it going to be the Pacifics doing what they did in 2015? Is it going to be the Diamonds, who have really done a good job of really being the upstart this season? They almost caught the Stompers in the final couple of games of the first half before the Stompers were able to clinch a couple of weeks back. So a lot of questions to be answered on the whole, but as far as tonight is concerned, the focus will be on the pitcher and the catcher for the Stompers, as Kelsie Whitmore will throw to Anna Kimbrell in this all-female battery, a historic night here at People's Home Equity Ballpark in Sonoma. So we're going to take our first break. When we come back, we'll give you the starting lineups. We'll have the national anthem and the first pitch here on SVTV 27, Comcast Cable. We'll be back.
We would like to thank our community partners, Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty, Myers Financial, Body Best Collision Center, Krista Granton Insurance, and Marbre Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice.
We're back here, and let's get to the starting lineups for both teams. Let's go first to the Pittsburg Diamonds, who come into this game in second place in the second half standings at 4-2, a game behind the San Rafael Pacifics. They are managed by former Major League player Aaron Miles, the Pittsburg native, in his second season as manager of the team. He'll lead off with David Kiriakos at second base tonight, followed by Thomas Scholl, the switch hitter, at shortstop. Nick Odo is the catcher batting third, and Mike Taylor, the cleanup hitter, is at first base. Rich Mejia will be at third base batting fifth. Tyler Norgren, the designated hitter, will bat sixth. Ian Hagemiller gets a start tonight in left field batting seventh. Jordan Yallen, who's good defensively in center, will bat eighth. And Kelly Starnes, one of those newcomers, will be in right field batting ninth. So there's your starting lineup for the Diamonds. That is what Kelsie Whitmore will have to deal with here tonight. The Diamonds overall have done their part as far as we talked about, really making it a kind of a dogfight in the overall standings. At 23-22, they're two games behind Sonoma and three behind first place overall San Rafael Pacifics. And the overall standings are important because depending on what happens in the second half of the season, whoever has the best overall record would host the championship game. And so Sonoma, having won the first half, if they end up with the best overall record and win the second half, then, you know, they get the title. But they still want to at least be the best overall record if it does come into a championship game situation, because then they'll get to host it. And last year they were in a situation where they were down a game to the San Rafael Pacifics and really needed to just win two games, two out of three in San Rafael. And the Pacifics swept that series and kept it in San Rafael for the title game. And for those of you who followed the team last year or might have read the book on the Stompers that was written by Ben Lindbergh and Sam Miller, The Only Rules That Has to Work, you almost know all too well what happened in that title game last year. And so the Stompers want to avoid that 100% completely, but they have to take care of business in the second half. And that's the idea tonight. So the Stompers will get ready to take the field here in just a moment. We will have the national anthem, as you can see them waiting in the shade. Although Takashi Miyoshi is okay with the sunlight. Should be fun. The Stompers and the Diamonds have had a really good back and forth all season long. We talked about the Diamonds run at the end of the season. They, with four games left, including one game that had to be resumed after it was suspended due to, yes, a fireworks show on July the 4th. The Diamonds were making the Stompers think about it a little bit. And you heard the roar there after Kelsie Whitmore and, pardon me, after Anna Kimbrell. And the roar is going to come here when Kelsie Whitmore's name. Pretty cool. And she gets a loud round of applause. Very cool atmosphere here at People's Home Equity Ballpark. As the Stompers will host the Diamonds. This is the first of three here. The Stompers in the midst of a seven-game homestand. They will actually play the Pacifics on Tuesday in a three-game series before going to San Rafael next weekend. So you see that a couple of times. The Stompers also have a week-long run against the Diamonds the week after that, where they will play two games in Sonoma before playing the final four games in Pittsburgh. And you can see the Batgirl today. Very happy. And as the meeting continues at the home plate area, we'll be ready here with, it looks like, our first pitch. And then we'll have our national anthem. Grace Cutting, the Sonoma Valley High School senior who's done a fine job singing the anthem this summer for the Stompers, will take the mic. And so it will be about game time here as we will have our ceremonial first pitch. And we'll hand it over to the public address announcer, stadium voice Trey Dunia.
Ladies and gentlemen, here to throw out the first pitch on this historic day is an all-star baseball player from Napa National Little League. On Tuesday night, while playing against the all-star team from San Francisco Little League, she was called onto the mound to pitch in an extra inning elimination game. One mistake and her team was going home. It was the bottom of the ninth, bottom of the eighth. Two on and one out. She struck out two to end the threat, then pitched the next two innings, striking out two more batters, giving up no runs, earning the win, and catapulting her team into the championship round. This young lady epitomizes the phrase that the Sonoma Stompers have heralded so often this season. If you can play, you can play. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to 11-year-old Peyton O'Hara.
And the southpaw with a slider in the back foot. Nicely done by Peyton O'Hara from the Napa National All-Star team. She gets a high five from Stacy Piagno. And it's time now for our national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, will you please rise and join us in honoring our great nation, our many veterans, and our men and women proudly serving our country at home and overseas with the singing of our national anthem. Today, the Star Spangled Banner will be performed live by 16-year-old Sonoma Valley High School student Grace Cutting.
Oh, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose bronze stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh,
She always kills it. Grace Cutting with the national anthem. And we're just about ready to go. It was back in 1943 that executives decided with the country at war in World War II, from a candy company, decided that it was time to give the people who were still here a chance to be entertained during a time of war. And that was the formation of the All-American Girls Professional Baseball League. And it lasted until 1954. Of course, famously, the story was told in the phenomenal movie, A League of Their Own. And now, almost 25 years after that movie comes out, depicting that tremendous time in baseball history, we actually get to see it in front of us. It's Anna Kimbrell behind the plate and Kelsie Whitmore on the hill, as two women will be the battery tonight in this phenomenally historic event here at People's Home Equity Ballpark. Let's get to the defensive alignment. In the outfield from left to right, it's Caleb Bryson, Cody Bishop, and then Derek Fox. On the infield from third to first, Eddie Moraloera. The shortstop is Chaz Meadows. Second baseman Yuki Yasuda and Daniel Baptista is at first base. Behind the plate, Anna Kimbrell and the pitcher, making her first start of the 2016 season, Kelsie Whitmore. She's seen most of her time in the field, in fact, all of her time in the field, although she has done pinch hitting roles before. Only 18 years old, from Temecula, California. She graduated from Temecula Valley High School. And right now, having only played softball once in her entire life, she has a full ride scholarship to Cal State Fullerton, one of the top programs in the country. And she's going to be here only, you know, through the end of the month before she goes off to perform in a showcase and then get ready for her time at Cal State Fullerton, although she will be back at some point in the middle of August for a weekend series here at home. But if you talk to any of the players on this team, they absolutely rave about Whitmore. She absolutely gets it 100%. She wants to learn something every pitch. She is always talking to somebody, whether it's manager Takashi Miyoshi, whether it's the bench coach Chris Matthews, the hitting coach Joel Carranza, who's really taken her under her wing. And now tonight she will face David Kyriakos to lead things off as the Sonoma Stompers put a woman on the mound and a woman behind the plate. And the first pitch is lifted high in the air to left center field, but it's definitely playable for Cody Bishop. And that's the first pitch. And the first out. And that ball will be saved, just in case. Nicely done. And you want to talk about efficiency, how about one pitch and one out? Didn't even get a chance to talk about Kyriakos' year, his third season in the Pacific Association. Here's the switch hitter, Thomas Scholl. And fastball's outside, ball one. Scholl has put together a really fine season as a middle infielder, hitting 243, but he's taken a lot of walks, and that's a fastball in there for a strike. Whitmore has a fastball, a slider, and her changeup is actually a knuckleball that she'll throw from time to time. 1-1. Swing and a miss. Challenged him with the fastball, and it's 1-2. And so Whitmore, you talk about her demeanor. She wants to go after. She shakes off two. And here's the next pitch. Swing and a bouncer towards short. Meadows, who's phenomenal with the glove, fires. Two gone. Here's Nick Godo. So right away, Kelsie Whitmore showing something on the hill. Odo this season hitting 286 with an OPS of 800, right on the nose, a 371 on base. He has four homers, 24 driven in. And the first pitch from Whitmore is outside, ball one. One and oh. And a swing and a miss, and that's the knuckleball. One and one. Hung up there, and this fell off. And she is going right after Odo. I mean, this 18-year-old, a true prodigy when it comes to female baseball, and that's fouled off to the left with Odo trying to go with it. And it's one and two. She joined the U.S. Women's National Team at the age of 16. Kimbrell was actually selected at the age of 15 before she had an ACL injury. And so these two have been on the radar since a very young age as Odo pops this up. Behind the mound, it's going to be Meadows settling under it. And that is a perfect first inning for Kelsie Whitmore. Bottom one coming up. The Stompers coming to bat on SVTV 27.
We would like to thank our community partners. Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty. Myers Financial. Body Best Collision Center. Krista Granton Insurance. And Marbray Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice. Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
We're back in the starting lineup for the Sonoma Stompers. We'll have Yuki Yasuda at second base, Chaz Meadows at shortstop, Derek Fox in right. Caleb Bryson in the cleanup spot tonight in left field. Daniel Baptista is at first base. Joel Carranza, the designated hitter, will bat sixth. Cody Bishop in center field will bat seventh. Anna Kimbrell will bat eighth as the catcher. And Eddie Morloera will be at third base batting ninth. The defense for the Pittsburgh Diamonds will have Ian Hagenmiller in left. In center field, Jordan Yallen. And in right field is the newcomer, Kelly Starnes. On the infield from third to first, Rich Mejia, Thomas Scholl, David Kiriakos, and Mike Taylor. The catcher is Nick Godot, catching the right-hander Dylan Brammer, who is in his 10th start, 5-2 with an even 4.0 earned run average, 40 strikeouts, 24 walks in 54 innings, 52 hits. And batters are hitting 250 against him. The right-hander, the opening day starter for the Diamonds. And as far as the advanced stats, for those of you who didn't follow the Stompers in 2016, of course, the Stompers had a sabermetric tilt to them, and we have those advanced stats now again in 2016, and FIP, which is a ERA-type statistic, which kind of accounts for the things a pitcher controls, walks, strikeouts, and homers. Brammer is at 3.91, and the further up you are, further, I should say, below your ERA, the better you're doing. And so Brammer right there at his ERA, so he's basically performed right to the way people would expect him. His first pitch is high, ball one to Yuki Yasuda. Yasuda in the leadoff spot with Matt Hibbert away from the team from personal reasons this weekend, and that's high, ball two. Hitting 303, 21 walks, 8 hit batters, 25 strikeouts, an 850 OPS, a 446 on base percentage. And the 2-0 to Yasuda is right there on the inside corner for a called strike. Hey, Yasuda in his second year with the Stompers. He was the defensive player of the year at second base last year. As the 2-1 is a bit, actually it is on the inside corner, and it's called strike two. The few hundred umpires behind home plate did not agree with that one. So 2-2 now from Brammer, who will come set, works primarily out of the stretch. And the 2-2, swinging a ball off the fist, fouled off to the right, and Yasuda will need a new piece. Brammer will sit in the high 80s with his fastball. It's mainly a cut fastball that he'll throw, but he has a two-seamer that he'll throw from time to time. But he's mainly cutter-slider, and a nice round of applause for the ball girl. And she comes on out. It's 2-2 to Yasuda as he gets a new piece of lumber. There's Brammer, who is in his second season with the Diamonds. He had a fine year last year in 2015, 26 years old, out of Marion High School in Mishawaka, Indiana. Went to University of Northwestern Ohio, same as Stompers pitcher Juan Espinosa, as that breaking ball is just fouled off enough by Yasuda to stay alive. It's actually, pardon me, his third season with the Diamonds. His first year, he was a little bit off. Although he struck out 89 batters in 81 innings, he was 3-6 with a 5.11 earned run average. Last year, was able to kind of turn in a good season as the breaking ball is taken low by Yasuda for ball three. So a full count now from Brammer. Last year was 6-0 with a 3.86 earned run average, 53 strikeouts in 56 innings. With a whip of 1.46. He's averaged a strikeout per inning in his 3 years. 3-2, swinging another foul off to the right. And so Yasuda just battling away here. This will be the ninth pitch of the at-bat. And there was a loud crash, it sounded like. Of course, the parking lot just over here to our right, it's foul ball territory. And so park at your own risk, unfortunately. 3-2 as Brammer tries to figure out Yasuda. And the pitch. Swinging a pop-up. This is in play. Taylor's going to come in from first. Brammer is going to call everybody off and make the play himself. You basically are not supposed to see that from a pitcher ever. You're supposed to let the fielders take care of balls like that. But instead, the nine-pitch at bat goes the way of Dylan Brammer. And here's Chaz Meadows, the shortstop. Meadows in his 13th game with the Stompers. He's a local product out of Concord. He is batting .273, 12 of 44, with two doubles and a triple, three driven in, four walks, nine strikeouts. Had a rough game last night going 0 for 4 with three Ks. But he is a wizard with the glove at shortstop, and he takes a fastball right down the middle for a called strike. It was a perfect top of the first for Kelsie Whitmore. Needed only nine pitches, a pop-up, a fly-out, and a ground-out. And that's a cutter down and away, ball one. And she went right after hitters. Got a swing and a miss on a couple. Threw a knuckleball to Nick Goto, that made him look a bit off as Meadows fouls this one off to the right. 1-2. A balmy day here in Sonoma. This is starting to kind of feel like the weather that you would normally expect here in our fine city, in the heart of wine country. Right now, 88 degrees at 6 p.m. It was a high of about 90, 91 at its peak, and it's going to burn off pretty quickly. It normally does. 1-2. Swinging a chopper towards third, and Mejia comes in to get it on the good hop, and he'll throw across for the second out. So here's Derek Fox. He was the MVP of the Pecos League in 2015. In his second season with the Stompers, he was with the team for the first few weeks of Sonoma's inaugural season in 2014. Didn't really get off to the best start, and then went back to Alpine in the Pecos League, which is where he starred the last two seasons. And he rejoins the Stompers this year, and he's been a great utility man for this team, a switch hitter that can play multiple positions. And it's a ball low. Professional, through and through. From Atlanta, Georgia, he is hitting .273 this year with an OPS of .712, one home run. He has walked more times than he has struck out. 1-0, and he takes at the knees for a called strike. A .371 on base for Fox. He has walked 25 times and struck out only 19. In his fifth season of professional baseball, and the 1-1 is low, ball two, as it goes off of Odo's shin guard. Caleb Bryson on deck if Fox can keep this going. That open stance, waiting on the 2-1 from Brammer, who's kind of labored in this first inning. The 2-1. Swinging a ball lifted in the shallow center. Yowen's going to charge in, and he will settle and make the catch. And so 1-2-3 go the Stompers, just like the Diamonds did in their half. We'll go to the second. Kelsie Whitmore and Anna Kimbrell coming back out. It's still scoreless here at People's Home Equity Ballpark. We'll be back.
Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small-town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
We're back here, second inning, scoreless as the Stompers and the Diamonds begin their three-game series, and you can see the finish there of the dizzy bat race as the Stompers all-female battery of Kelsie Whitmore and Anna Kimbrell are back out there ready to go. Nine pitches for Whitmore in that first inning. Got a fly out, a ground out, and a pop out. And now she'll have a good test here against Mike Taylor. Taylor, a year ago, had 24 home runs for the Diamonds. This year, kind of a little bit off, although he still hit eight homers as that fastball is on the outside corner for a called strike. Hitting only .218, but leads the team with those eight homers and 28 driven in. Struck out 37 times in 153 plate appearances, and he waves through that slider. Nothing in two. Has an OPS of .655. 0-2. Whitmore's fastball is low, 1-2. And the pitch, slider chopped foul as Taylor just got enough. That's good movement on that pitch. It's got some pretty good tilt, as what they would call on a slider. That's the diagonal dip on the pitch. Swinging a pop up, left field. That's gonna really get out there. And that thing actually gets gone. That thing actually got out of here. That looked like just a routine fly ball to left, and Taylor just got enough to lift it out to left center. And it's 1-0. That looked like it was just a kind of a routine fly ball. In fact, Bryson out there in left thought the same. And that thing somehow got out of here. And it's 1-0. So that's the ninth homer of the season by Taylor. And that pitch is popped up. Behind the plate is Kimbrell chasing after, and she can't get to it. She didn't find it in time. And that's a strike. Oh-1, swinging a ball off the end of the bat, and it's blooped into center field for a base hit. And so back-to-back hits, one a solo homer here for Whitmore, against Whitmore here in the second. And here's Tyler Nordgren. Nordgren is hitting .389, 14 for his first 36 with the team, has driven in six. And with him swinging a hot bat, they've put him into the DH role, even though he is also the backup catcher. First pitch rolled over towards third. Morlera has it. He's going to go to second for one. Yasuda to first, and Nordgren, even with catcher speed, is able to beat it out. And so it's a fielder's choice, 5-4, and there's one gone. So here's Hagen Miller, who has struggled this year, 7 for 44, and he has struck out 25 times in those 44 at-bats. And that's a drive into right center field, and going back onto this Fox, and it's past him. He'll get up against the scoreboard. Fox will dig it out. Going to second is Hagen Miller, and the throw home will be in time with Kimbrell knocking it down. Runners at second and third, though, with one gone here in the second. So Jordan Yallen will come up. Yallen getting a start in center field with Hinshaw not in the lineup tonight. He is hitting only .176 this year with a .488. OPS, as Whitmore out of the stretch again, will fire, and a slider drops in there for a called strike. More of a curveball there, and now Kimbrell and Whitmore want to have a discussion. So now Kimbrell, I think, wanted to talk signs. It's the first time there's been a runner at second. And so they wanted to go over some indicators as Yallen waiting at the plate now. 0-1. Fastball, and that gets by Kimbrell. She had no shot at it. And coming in to score will be Tyler Nordgren. It's 2-0. So going to third on the play is Hagen Miller, as it's now 2-0. One and one now to Yallen. So Whitmore will go out of the windup now. The 1-1 pitch here, and that's a slider, and Kimbrell lets it get faster, but Hagen Miller wasn't able to get to it or see it from that angle, and he'll stay put. It's 2-1. So Mike Taylor led off with a homer that was really a pop-up that in any other park in this league would have been caught. Instead, it turned into a homer. And then after that, a single, a double, and a wild pitch. 2-1, and that's high ball 3. So Whitmore having her issues in this second inning after a clean first. But now the 3-1 offering. Swinging a bouncer right back to her, and now she's going to throw home with Hagemiller coming. And Kimbrell is going to throw down, and the tag is made by Morlo-Era. The throw down to second, and it's not in time. So going to second on that throw, and they almost had Jordan Yellen, but there's two away on the heads-up play there by Whitmore and Kimbrell. So with two out and a runner at second now, here's the first pitch, high ball one to Kelly Starnes, newcomer here for the Diamonds. Starnes is 0-for-1, but has walked four times and takes another pitch high, 2-0. And so Whitmore setting high, and the 2-0, and it's there, oh, a little bit low, I guess, ball three. On deck is the leadoff man, David Kyriakos. 3-0, and that's high, ball four. And so Starnes, who's walked five out of six plate appearances now with the Diamonds, will jog on down to first, and Takashi Miyoshi, the Stomper manager, will come out and have a talk with his pitcher. And so the first inning went cleanly. It was nine pitches, three up, three down. And Whitmore being told by Yoshi couple of tips here in this second inning. It was Mike Taylor's solo homer that got this all started. And then a single on a little bloop to shallow center, and then a double to right center by Hagemiller. A wild pitch brought home the second run, but Whitmore was able to get a comebacker, and then a rundown got Hagemiller coming off the bag at third for the second out. And now after the walk with runners at first and second, she has one more out to go as Kyriakos comes to the plate, the seventh hitter of the inning for the Diamonds. And on the first pitch of this game, he lifted one into medium deep center field. Crowd trying to get behind Whitmore here to get out of this inning as the first pitch is outside, ball one. Each pitch that's even close, these fans are hoping for a strike. 1-0, and that's a knuckleball that misses outside, 2-0. So that knuckleball she uses as kind of her changeup, and she'll step off here to look Yellen back to second. 2-0, and that's outside, ball three. And now Whitmore, having thrown seven consecutive balls, can't find the strike zone. Gosh, Miyoshi told her this is your inning to finish. There's nobody up in the bullpen, nothing like that right now. Only 2-0 here in the second. 3-0, and that's outside, ball four. And Yellen had a huge lead off behind her, and now the bases have been loaded here for Thomas Scholl. And so the left-handed hitting Scholl, who bounced out to short his first time up, nowhere to put him. So Whitmore's going to have to throw some strikes here, and time will be called as Kyriakos wanted to rid himself of his protective wear that he comes to the plate with. And now the first pitch from Whitmore is high, ball one. And so she has lost the strike zone. Unfortunately, these last two hitters, nine straight balls now. Whitmore with the 1-0, swing and a miss. And it's 1-1 with Scholl taking a big cut. Whitmore trying to get out of this inning without any more damage. 1-1. Swinging a ball lined in the left field. That's a base hit. Coming in to score, Yowen. Behind him will be Kelly Starnes. And it's 4-0. And the Diamonds have opened it up here in the second. So it's Nick Otto coming to the plate from the left side here with two outs. Four runs in for the Diamonds. And the first pitch is a slider that's on the inside corner for a called strike. And a step off there by Whitmore as both runners were trying to go before the pitch was even thrown. So Whitmore ahead 0-1. And that one's bounced sharply right to Baptista. He'll knock it down, and he'll take it himself, and that ends the inning. But four runs come home as Kelsie Whitmore runs into some trouble here in the second. We'll go to the bottom half. Stompers trailing 4-0 here on the Stompers Radio Network.
We would like to thank our community partners. Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty. Myers Financial. Body Best Collision Center. Krista Granton Insurance. And Marbre Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice.
The Stompers trail 4-0 here as the Diamonds open things up a bit. It started with the Mike Taylor leadoff homer, and then after a wild pitch and some walks to load the bases, the Stompers saw the Diamonds cash in, and it was a big lead for the Diamonds after that, as it will be, as you can see, the mascot race taking place. Rawhide not in top shape. He's got a little guy to catch. And down the stretch they come. And he didn't even touch home plate, but that's still a winner. He had some good wheels. So it'll be Dylan Brammer facing 4-5-6 for the Stompers in this one. It'll be Caleb Bryson, Daniel Baptista. And then the Stompers DH, Joel Carranza. Martin Cronin has gotten up in the bullpen for the Stompers, so it looks like he's getting ready to come in the third. As the Stompers now trail by the score of 4-0. And Dylan Brammer, who had his issues in the first inning, was able to get out of it, though, 1-2-3 after a nine-pitch battle with Yuki Yasuda. We'll see Caleb Bryson come to the plate. So here's Bryson. Bryson, who really started off the year like gangbusters. He at one point was hitting .358 with an OPS of near 1,100. He has seen his average drop down to .259. Eight homers, 28 driven in, but he's been drawing a lot of walks. He's still at an .856 OPS, and he takes high ball one. From Thomasville, Georgia, playing left field tonight. He's played a lot of third base. And it will be a power versus power matchup here as he takes high ball two. Brammer hitting 91 miles an hour on that fastball. That four-seamer he'll throw from time to time. It's kind of a show-me pitch. He stays mainly with that cut fastball. As Brammer behind 2-0, swinging a pop-up as Bryson got a good pitch there, but it's 2-1. There's a little breeze on this warm evening. That'll feel good. Bryson trying to get the Stompers going here in the second inning. 2-1. Swing and a miss on a cutter. 2-2. So Brammer challenging Bryson here after the 2-0 count. And now it's up to the Stompers left fielder to make his adjustment. The 2-2 pitch. And that is up and in. Did he go? No, says Eric Thompson. And it's a full count, 3-2. Bryson hit 32 homers with the Pecos League last year in only 62 games. Or 30 homers, pardon me, in 62 games. There was a 2 in there somewhere. I want to make sure I got in the right spot. 3-2 now to Bryson. And that's taken high, ball 4. And Thompson again says he didn't go on a very short check swing. And the Stompers have the leadoff runner aboard here for Daniel Baptista. So Baptista, who's hit the ball hard at times, in fact, a lot of times in the beginning of this season, but has unfortunately seen some bad luck on those hits deep into the outfield. He is hitting .263 with a .681 OPS with 2 homers from nearby Fairfield, his second season with the Stompers. Big, powerful left-handed hitter. Bryson, not a lot of speed over at first base. As Brammer with the first pitch is low, ball 1, and Odo thought about it. But Bryson wasn't too far off the bag in the first place. Baptista waiting on the 1-0 here from Brammer. Swinging a line shot in the left field, a base hit. That fastball, which he wanted on the outer half, was left up. And a nice piece of hitting there by Baptista to go the other way. And the Stompers have something going here. And they need it. Down 4-0 as Joel Carranza with power strides to the plate. 293 this year with 7 home runs, 24 driven in, an OPS of .813. In his third season with the Stompers, he is the franchise leader in home runs with 36. Back in 2014, he set the league record with 19 homers in the 78-game Pacific Association season from Pembroke Pines, Florida. And he swings at the first pitch and fouls it off to the right, 0-1. He spent 2 months with the Stompers last year before getting called up to the Canadian-American Association, the Can-Am League, and joined the Three Rivers Eagles, or as they say in Quebec, the Trois-Rivières Aigles. 0-1, swinging a ball off the end of the bat, almost hitting Cody Bishop in the on-deck circle, and it's 0-2. And down the stretch, he played well for them and helped them to a championship. And after kind of a rough start with the Eagles to begin this season, the Eagles just overall had a rough start. And that start has lingered into a season almost. Carranza was let go, and the Stompers were quick to pick him up as Odo calls time. So Brammer can step off and get a new set of signals with Bryson at second. Baptiste at first. 0-2 here to Carranza. And the pitch, swinging a foul back. And hey, there goes our camera. Again, this happened last night a couple of times. And we're going to need some help out here. So pardon us as we stick to some different camera angles for this at bat. There's Bryson at second. Brammer sets. And the 0-2, swinging a bouncer towards third, going to second for one, and on to first two, a double play. And so Carranza hits into a pitcher's best friend there with nobody out, and Bryson's now at third with two away. Here's Cody Bishop. Two outs now for the Stomper center fielder. He's normally in right field, but with Hibbert gone for the weekend, Bishop is in center field tonight. Had three hits last night against the Pacifics, his best game so far. And the first pitch is taken up for ball one. Hitting 278, he's 10 for his first 36 with a double. And he tore up the Pecos League where he was playing earlier this season. And the 1-0, and that's low ball two. Hit 429 down there with an OPS of almost 1,300. 16 homers. Led the league before he left with 61 driven in. Had 17 doubles as well. This is his fifth season of professional baseball, his ninth team. He has traveled the country playing this game. 25 years old. And the 2-0. And that's actually on the outside corner for a called strike. 2-1 from Mount Pleasant, Texas. Frontier League with Florence in 2015. American Association with Gary and Sioux Falls. It's 2-1. And the pitch, swinging a chopper towards first. Taylor will wait on it. Toss to Brand recovering. And he gets out of a runner at first and second with nobody out situation. Without allowing a run. We'll go to the third. Diamonds lead 4-0 here on SVTV 27. We'll be back.
Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
We're back. Sonoma trailing 4-0. And Kelsie Whitmore, who had some trouble in the second inning, comes back out. And it'll be 3-4-5 for the Diamonds here in this second inning. Nick Odo, followed by Mike Taylor, and then Rich Mejia. As Whitmore, who threw a perfect first inning, ran into some issues in that second inning, and it began with Mike Taylor, who hit a solo homer. I was actually mistaken. Taylor will lead off as Odo came to bat in that second inning. Nine batters to the plate for the Diamonds. And it will be Whitmore facing Taylor for the second time. He took a fastball, what looked like a kind of a sky-high pop-up or fly ball to left center, and it got out of here. It's a short porch to straightaway left, only about 330 feet. And out there where Taylor hit, it's only about 350. And there's really no wind either, and so that thing just had enough loft on it to get out of here. As the first pitch is in the dirt for ball one. Taylor waiting on the 1-0, and it's outside ball two. Whitmore had her issues in that inning walking two. And is behind 2-0 here to Taylor. And that fastball taken all the way for a strike, 2-1. Taylor wanted to make sure Whitmore could get one over, and she does. And now Whitmore needs to do it again behind 2-1. And the pitch, outside ball three. Whitmore, a deep breath, and the 3-1, and that is low, ball four, and her third walk now. And we mentioned Martin Cronin throwing in the bullpen, and so you have to think that if she's going to run into more trouble here in the third, that they're going to go to the recently activated right-hander as Mejia to the plate. He singled off the end of the bat into center his first time up, and he fouls one back there with a big cut. Nothing and one. Whitmore, as time is called, they want to make sure the ball got out of play. The ball girl coming on to grab it. Whitmore with Taylor at first. Setting. 0-1. Breaking ball, and that's in there for a strike. Mejia was looking for the hard fastball there, and instead watches strike two go by. So 0-2. Taylor jumps off, and that's lined up the middle and through for a base hit. So Taylor will go to second, and I think that's going to do it for Kelsie. As Takashi is coming out, and they're going to go to the bullpen here. So the fifth hit, and Kelsie Whitmore is going to hand the ball over to Takashi Yoshi, and she'll get a nice ovation here from the crowd as Martin Cronin will come on. But Kelsie Whitmore in her first start, her and Anna Kimbrell making history tonight as the first female battery in men's professional baseball history. And as she walks off, Martin Cronin will walk on. We'll take a break and be back to talk about the new pitcher after this.
We would like to thank our community partners, Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty, Myers Financial, Body Best Collision Center, Krista Granton Insurance, and Marbre Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice.
We're back as Martin Cronin has come on. It's his first appearance since earlier this month in July. The Stompers deactivated him and then reactivated him yesterday. In his 9 appearances, a 1.25 earned run average, but he has allowed 27 base runners in 14 and a third innings. He came in after some errors ahead of him during a game where he relieved Jose Flores and then proceeded to give up a few runs in that start. And so the total runs are at 13 in 14 and a third innings. He's from the Woodlands in Texas. Sinker baller with a slider and a good changeup. And it'll be his job now to try and get one of those ground balls and get out of this inning. And earlier in the season, Cronin was one of those beneficiaries of bad luck behind him as he was getting the ground balls, but the Stompers' infield defense, which was a little bit difficult at times, was not getting the job done. And Cronin, when he came on with runners already aboard, turned into a situation where he was unable to get out of the inning, and it wasn't of his own fault. He was getting the ground balls. He was trying to give something to his defense to work with. And now the question is, will he be able to get the Stompers out of this jam here in the third? Nobody out, two on, as Tyler Norgren, who grounded into that fielder's choice on the comebacker, steps up. First pitch, and that's lined into center field over the leaping Meadows for a base hit. Taylor's going to round third. He will come home to score, and it's 5-0 Diamonds. Here's Hagen Miller, who doubled in the right center field. I should say that Norgren actually grounded to third base on that fielder's choice. But now in a 5-0 ball game, here's Ian Hagen Miller. Hagen Miller doubled into right center his last time up, as Cronin looks to second, and the first pitch is a slider, and it's going to get by Kimbrell. and get to the backstop as runners will move up to second and third on ball one. So this crowd has gotten silent. And that pitch is fouled back, 1-1. One and one now to Cronin, or from Cronin, and that's high, 2-1. Hagen Miller with a couple runners in scoring position here. And the 2-1, and that's high, ball three. And so 3-1 here to Hagen Miller. And Cronin has to throw a strike here. The 3-1, and that's right there. First strike, 3-2. Another one of those for Cronin. He'll be in good spirits. A 5-0 ball game. Cronin in a strikeout situation, the 3-2. Slider fouled off to the right. And we'll do it again. So Kelsie Whitmore threw a perfect first inning, got into trouble in the second, a leadoff homer by Mike Taylor, and then three more runs in the fourth, and then a walk and a leadoff, or pardon me, a leadoff walk and a single have chased her from this third inning. So 3-2 now from Martin Cronin, and a check swing, and Hagen Miller just gets enough to stay alive as that pitch was up on his hands. And we'll do it again. So Mejia at third, Norgren at second. Hagen Miller, the eighth pitch of this at-bat against Cronin. And the pitch, slider high, ball four. And the bases are loaded as Cronin, now with nowhere to put Jordan Yallen, we'll see him coming to the plate. Yallen. Grounded back to the pitcher on a fielder's choice. Went to second on the play. And now Cronin would love a comebacker. As he'll set at the belt. And the first pitch is down and away, ball one. Cronin gave up a single to bring in one of the inherited base runners. And also has thrown a wild pitch and had a walk. 1-0. Slider up and in, 2-0. And so Cronin has not come in and fared much better. Still nobody out in this third inning. And this game getting away from the Stompers. 5-0 ball game already. 2-0, swinging a foul to the right. So it's 2-1. At third, Mejia. At second, Nordgren. And at first, Hagen Miller. As Cronin, 2-1. And time's called as Cronin came set almost exactly the same time Yallen stepped in the box. And so a reset on both ends here. So 2-1 now as Cronin sets and fires. And that's right there on the outside corner for strike two. Cronin would love a ground ball here. Allen will be hard to double off, but one hard ground ball could mean two as a breaking ball swung on and fouled off. And Allen stays alive, and we'll do it again. Cronin trying to get out of this situation here. The 2-2 slider fouled right back. That hung up there. And we'll do it again. Cronin's been a bit all over the place with his pitches. He's not been able to hit the strike zone consistently, although he has had a lot of strikes. And the 2-2. Bouncer to short. Could be two. Meadows will go to second for one. And it almost pulls Yasuda off the bag. And it does. And Meadows is saying that Yasuda was able to get the foot down in time. But the errant throw by Meadows brings home another run. It's 6-0. And again, a ground ball from Cronin. And again, an error behind him. So an RBI there, and now the first pitch up and in for ball one. 6-0 now here, Pittsburgh with the lead. One oh, and that's there for a strike. So 1-1 here from Cronin. And the pitch, slider swung on a miss, and it's 1-2. Starnes walked in that second inning, came around to score. Cronin, nod of the head. And now the 1-2. And a swing and a bouncer to third. Morlow Arrow is going to come home with it. Kimbrell's going to go to first, not in time. So it'll be a fielder's choice with the run cut down at home. One out. So here's David Kiriakos with one out. And the pitch, and it's a chopper right behind home plate for strike one. Oh, 1, way up high, and that wild pitch gets all the way to the backstop, and it's 1-1. Cronin has been all over the place here since coming in. One in the dirt. A nice block there by Kimbrell. 2-1. And the 2-1, outside ball three, and nowhere to put Kiriakos here for Cronin. Cronin sitting at the belt, and the 3-1, and that's reach four by Kiriakos for some reason, and it's fouled off to the right, and it's a full count now, 3-2. 3-2. Cronin's pitch on the way. Slider, and that's lifted in the air to shallow left field. Bryson coming on. Dives and makes the catch. And he keeps Hagenmiller from coming in, since Hagenmiller was thinking that was going to fall. And a nice defensive play there by Bryson. There's two away now in the inning. Bryson, who hadn't really played much left this year, his main position was third base. He actually played a lot of it in the Pecos League last year. He was kind of a left fielder by trade, since the team there had already a lot of infielders. As the first pitch here from Cronin is a curveball missing outside for ball one. And so Cronin trying to get one more out here to get the Stompers back in the dugout. The Diamonds have been all over it in these first three innings. 1-0, and that's down and away, and it'll get away from Kimbrell. But Hagenmiller again was at an angle where he couldn't see it. It was directly down the line away from him. He couldn't see just how far it got away, and he has to stay put. It's 2-0. And Cronin really not hitting his target. Kimbrell was set up on the outside corner there. And Cronin, that pitch was almost all the way back towards the left-handed batter's box off the plate inside. And Kimbrell trying to reach across there was unable to make the play. The 2-0, and that slider is in there for a called strike, 2-1. Four runs in the second, two runs here in the third. Cronin gets what he wants. And the 2-1, and that's high ball three, and there's nowhere to put Thomas Scholl. He's got to come into him here. That's now 30 pitches for Cronin since entering this game. With nobody out and runners at first and second in this third inning. Here comes pitch number 31. And that's in there for a strike. And it's a full count, 3-2. And so everybody will be off on the pitch. Swing and a bouncer towards first, and it's a foul ball just to the left, or pardon me, the right of the bag. And Baptista, having knocked that one down with a good amount of effort, is all for naught. It's just another pitch coming to Scholl. Swing and a foul off to the left, and Scholl chased a pitch up there. Most likely was ball four. But we'll do it again. Scholl this season has really done a fine job here with the Diamonds, just as an overall utility guy. 3-2, down and in, ball four. And Cronin walks in a run. It's 7-0. And now he has to face Nick Godo. That run is going to be unearned. But at the same time, this inning, getting away, Cronin has been all over the place with his pitches. He's thrown 34 pitches now, having faced six batters, and it'll be Nick Odo coming to the plate now at the bases loaded. Odo having a very good season. He's 0-for-2 tonight, though. He has popped out to short, and he has grounded out to first base. First pitch coming here. And it's a pop-up, shallow left field, and this one is going to fall in there for a base hit. Kind of an excuse-me hit, a little Texas leaguer. Two more come in, and it's now 9-0. And here's Mike Taylor. And so this inning has become a nightmare. First pitch, slider, bounced sharply to Meadows, it's short. He's going to go over to first, and it's in the dirt, but Baptista's able to pick it out. And that ends this inning, finally. But the Diamonds put across five and have really taken control of this game. It's 9-0 here at People's Home Equity Ballpark as the Stompers and the Diamonds lead off this three-game series. We'll be back.
We would like to thank our community partners, Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty, Myers Financial, Body Best Collision Center, Krista Granton Insurance, and Marbray Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice.
So bottom third, and Dylan Brammer will be back out there as his team has taken a 9-0 lead in this one. They chased Kelsie Whitmore in the third after scoring four times in the second inning. And then after a walk and a single in the third, Whitmore was relieved by Martin Cronin, and he allowed both of the inherited runners to come in and score. And then from there, three more on his watch. And so the Diamonds, with a 9-0 lead, have kind of spoiled the party here tonight, so to speak, as Anna Kimbrell will lead things off in this third inning for the Stompers. A nice ovation here as she steps to the plate. Kimbrell, we mentioned, has played for the U.S. Women's National Team. This will be her eighth year with the team. She joined it at the age of 17. She actually was going to be with the team as a 15-year-old, and the first pitch is high, ball one. That's how highly she was thought of, but she tore her ACL in high school, and she needed to recuperate from that. She then went on to join the team in 2008. She's helped them to two silver medals and two bronze medals at the Women's World Cup. 1-0, and that's taken on the inside corner for a strike. Last year, helped the U.S. Women's National Team to a gold medal at the Pan Am Games. She famously was the catcher in Stacy Piagno's no-hitter against Puerto Rico. 1-1, swings and fouls one into the glove there of Odo. It's 1-2. Brammer has thrown 36 pitches as we just start the third. And now the 1-2, swinging a foul back, and Kimbrell stays alive. The Diamonds turning into a party offensively in this early going. But the Stompers have plenty of time to try and make their way back into this one as that pitch is up and away, ball two. Brammer has allowed only one hit, one walk, both of those coming to lead off the second inning. 2-2, swing and a pop-up. And it'll be Brammer who calls everybody off, and for the second time in this game, he will make the catch on a pop-out. One gone. So here's Eddie Moraloera. Moraloera comes into this game hitting 252, a homer, 19 driven in, He has a 696 OPS, buoyed by a 376 on base percentage. 19 walks. As the first pitch to him is right down the middle for a strike. Nothing in one. Brammer setting at the belt. And the 0-1, swing and a miss on a cutter. It's nothing in two. So rough go of it. Whitmore's final line, 2 innings, 5 hits, 6 runs. She walks 3. 44 pitches, 25 of them for strikes. This time is called. Oh, 2, way outside for ball 1. One, 2, and that cutter, strike 3 called on the outside corner. And there's 2 away now, as Morlowera goes down on the first strikeout of the night for Brammer. First strikeout on either end, as Yuki Yasuda comes to the plate. And the pitch is fouled back by Yasuda. Nothing in one. He popped out in foul territory to Brammer after a 9-pitch war that was won by the Diamonds ace. And that pitch is on the outside corner. First strike, nothing in two. So it was a festive atmosphere to start here. It's gone quiet as the Diamonds have taken control early on. And Yasuda now waiting on the 0-2 pitch from Brammer. And he bounces this one to second. Kyriakos has it. Routine, throws to first, and that ends this inning. So 1-2-3 go to the Stompers here in the third. We go to the fourth. Sonoma trailing 9-0 here on SVTV. We'll be back.
Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
We're getting ready for our race to Rawhide here, as these two youngsters will go from first and third respectively to go put on a Stomper jersey and helmet before getting back home. And both smartly going jersey before helmet here. And it's going to be a race to the finish here. Both of them rounding. One of them took too wide of a turn. This might be simultaneous, and it is. They almost run into each other. And I don't think they were expecting that. But there was almost a collision. That was definitely the closest race we've had all year. But this game, which started very well with Kelsie Whitmore getting the first 3 hitters on only 9 pitches, the Diamonds kind of charged forward in the second. Mike Taylor hit a homer to left. And then a hit, a double, a wild pitch. And then after a couple of walks, a two-out single, and the Stompers trail by four, and then the Diamonds were able to get the first two on against Whitmore in the third, chasing her from the game. And then Martin Cronin came on to pitch for the Stompers, gave up the two inherited runs, and then gave up three more of his own. And so it's now 9-0. And Rich Mejia, who is 2-for-2 today, will stand in. Against Martin Cronin, who will begin his second inning of work. And the first pitch is a bouncer right back up the middle and through for a base hit. So Mejia is now 3-for-3. And they are just hitting the Stompers around here early on. That's now 8 hits in this game for the Diamonds. And we just began the fourth. Norgren is 1-for-2. He has singled. He has brought home a run. And he has scored a run himself. Cronin with the first pitch. And that's a fastball off the plate away for ball one. Cronin setting at the belt. The 1-0 slider swung on a miss as Norgren trades to pitch up, and it's 1-1. One and one here as time is called. One and one here from Martin Cronin. And the pitch is bounced towards first, but it's through for a base hit as Baptista was holding the runner on. And so Cronin has allowed a couple of ground balls through holes. And now, again, runners at first and second with nobody out for the third straight inning. Actually, in the second inning, it was runners at second and third with nobody out. Hagen Miller is 1-for-1 with a double and a walk along with a run scored. Cronin will fire away here, and there's a slider swung on and missed. Cronin. Time called here is Kimbrell trying to get the signs down. Cronin can't see him through the shadows. Now he can pick him up. 0-1. Slider lifting in the air down the right field line. And this one is slicing. And it's a fair ball just inside the chalk. Coming in to score is Mejia. And it's double figures now for the Diamonds on another double by Hagen Miller. It's 10-0. As this just keeps going on and on here. So Yellen standing in now, 0-for-2. He's bounced into a couple of fielder's choices. First pitch, and it's high, ball one with the slider. One and 0 here from Cronin. And that pitch is lifted in the air down the right field line again. Fox is over on the run, and he makes the catch falling over on top of the line. Coming in to score on the sac fly is Norgren, and going to third is Hagen Miller. It's 11-0. Thank you. So Hagen Miller going to third there. And the first pitch is a slider, low for ball one. One-oh, and that fastball's on the inside corner for a called strike. Cronin with the 1-1 and a slider missing high, ball two. And so Cronin has allowed five runs himself in one and a third. As the 2-1, swinging a bouncer up the middle. Meadows behind the bag is able to make it on the short hop. Throws across in time, but coming in to score will be Hagen Miller, and it's 12-0. So with two outs, here's Kiriakos. Base is clear, but that is three more runs coming in here for the Diamonds. As the first pitch to Kiriakos, lifted in the air to center. Right at Bishop. He'll barely move, and he'll make the catch, and that ends the inning. But the Diamonds continue their onslaught. Three more here in the fourth, and Pittsburgh now leads 12-0 here. We'll be back on SVTV.
We would like to thank our community partners, Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty, Myers Financial, Body Best Collision Center, Krista Granton Insurance, and Marbre Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice.
We're back. It's 12-0. That's the score here in Sonoma. The Pittsburgh Diamonds have just busted this game open. Four runs in the second, five runs in the third, three runs in the fourth. And this game has gotten away, unfortunately, from Sonoma. It began very well with Kelsie Whitmore getting the first three out in a row on only nine pitches. But then Mike Taylor hit a homer to left center that looked almost like a routine fly ball for most of it, but just kept going for his ninth homer of the season. And then from there it was on. The Diamonds scored three more times in the second. They came up with five of those next runs in the third and then put three more up there in the fourth inning. And now Sonoma trails 12-0 as this is turning into one of their most difficult losses of the season already. They're deficits, I should say. 12-0 the score. As Brammer will face 2-3-4, Chaz Meadows, Derek Fox, and then Caleb Bryson. Meadows to the plate. He bounced out to third his first time up. As the shortstop will stand in to lead things off against Brammer. Has allowed two base runners in his first three innings with a strikeout. And the first pitch is right there for a called strike. And the 0-1, a cutter missing outside for ball one. Sonoma has had no luck with Brammer in the first three innings, while the Diamonds, with 10 hits already in this game, blowing it open. There's Brammer setting. And the 1-1, way inside for ball two.
Yeah.
And the pitch popped up. Second base, and it's going to be Kiriakou settling under it to make the catch. One gone. Here's Derek Fox. Fox today is flied out to center. Standing in from the left side. As the switch hitter waits on the first pitch here from Brammer, and it's fouled off to the left. So this game had a lot of fanfare coming in. And right now, it's unfortunately a somewhat quiet crowd here at People's Home Equity Ballpark. The 0-1 pitch, and that's a swing and a miss on a two-seamer. It's nothing in two. Fox, he's played multiple positions. He's played second, third, and short. He's played left field. He's played right field. He basically told the Stompers he'll play wherever they put him. 0-2, and that's way up high for ball one, and it gets by the catcher Odo to the backstop. Shadows almost completely across the infield. As Odo gets the sign out to Brammer. Now it's 1-2 to Derek Fox. And that just misses down and away for ball two. Fox, tough to strike out. We've talked about he's only struck out 19 times this season. And that has come in 206 plate appearances. The 2-2, swinging a sharp grounder towards second. Kiriakou's over to his left, has it, and will throw to first to complete the second out. So here's Bryson, who drew a walk in his first plate appearance. That led off the second inning. He's had his troubles as far as putting the ball in play. Leads the team in strikeouts. But he has still been able to get on base. He has a .381 on base coming into this game. So leads the team in walks. As the first pitch is a cutter off the plate away for ball one. 51 strikeouts, but 27 walks. So leads the team with 28 runs driven in. Brammer with the 1-0, and that's at the knees for a called strike. It's one of the major adjustments you have to make in this league. It's how to handle that outside pitch. Once they know that you can turn on something inside, you're going to get pitched away, away, away. 1-1, and that cutter's way upstairs for 2-1 now. And Bryson has had to make that adjustment. That's the big adjustment in this league is, what can you do with that outside pitch? As the 2-1 is on the way, and that's in the dirt, ball three. He has been trying to go the opposite way in batting practice. He's really been working with Takashi Miyoshi and Chris Matthews, the manager and bench coach specifically, on what to do with his approach at the plate. The 3-1 on the way, and that is a strike at the knees. Bryson thought it was ball four. It's a full count now, 3-2. He thought that was a bit low. Daniel Baptista on deck for Sonoma. If Bryson can get on. Brammer ready with the 3-2 pitch. Swinging a sharp grounder to short, backhanded by Scholl on the short hop, and he'll throw across to first, and that ends the inning. So another 1-2-3 inning for Brammer. We will head to the fifth. Sonoma trailing 12-0 here on SVTV. We'll be back.
Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
We're back here in the fifth inning. It is 12-0 as the Stompers have had their issues in this game. The Diamonds scoring four times in the second, five times in the third, and three times in the fourth. Martin Cronin on for his third inning, as Anna Kimbrell remains behind the plate. Game two of this three-game series will be tomorrow at 5 p.m. here at People's Home Equity Ballpark in Sonoma. Tickets available online at stompersbaseball.com. And you can call 707-938-7277 for more information. That game will be on the radio. We will not be televised tomorrow. And so go online to stompersbaseball.com or go to the TuneIn app on your mobile device and search for Sonoma Stompers. You can follow us, favorite us as well, and it'll be Jeff Safford, my assistant, on the call tomorrow evening. Tim Livingston with you here in Sonoma, as Thomas Scholl will come to the plate. Martin Cronin, who entered the game in the third inning in relief of Kelsie Whitmore, he's given up five runs in his two innings, but in this 12-0 game, his job is to eat up some more, as that fastball is at the knees for a called strike to Scholl. One for two with three driven in. He drove in two with a single to left, and also drew a bases-loaded walk. 0-1, and that's fouled off to the left, nothing and two. The Stompers have a couple of arms down there that they like to see some work tonight. That's Juan Espinosa, along with Jose Flores. But the way they've been performing, they normally like to bring those guys in when they have the lead late in the game. Is that 0-2 is up high, ball one. Flores, who pitched in the Milwaukee Brewer system, has been the closer. But Cronin, his job right now is to just get as many outs as he can, as that 1-2 is a broken bat blooper over the mound, barehanded by Meadows across his body. He got him. And that right there is a web gem by Meadows. One gone. That's the type of defense that Takashi Miyoshi has just raved about with this young man. And here's Nick Otto. Otto 1-for-3. He drove into with the bloop single down the left field line. In his last at-bat, before that, he popped out to short and grounded out to first base, as Jesse Holliday has gotten up the southpaw for the Stompers, and that hits Otto, a fastball up and in, and he'll take his base. So one on with one out here for Mike Taylor. Taylor is 1-for-2. He has that solo homer in his first at-bat back in the second. He then walked in the third. He batted twice in that inning, ending it on a ground ball to shortstop. First pitch, slider, fouled right back. It's nothing and one. Piagno, Stacy Piagno, the other female Stomper player, pitched last night through two scoreless innings. There's a chance she might get used tonight. But we talked about how there's been a lot of bullpen arms that haven't gotten a lot of looks, and Holiday's one of them. That's why he's been up, is Cronin with a one-hopper over to first to check on Otto in a 12-0 game. Kind of odd. Otto ain't going anywhere. 0-1. Slider lined in the left field, a base hit. Hung up there a bit too much. And Taylor with his second hit of the night. Puts runners at first and second. So here's Mejia, 3-for-3 tonight. Couple of singles against Cronin. Cronin would love to get a ground ball here. And the first pitch is fouled right back, and it's nothing and one. So this game, which has gotten away from the Stompers, has turned into a game the Diamonds are relishing, especially considering the Stompers held them off at the end of the first half. 0-1, slider fouled off to the right. And it's nothing and two. Mejia trying to stay perfect on the day. Three hits in his first three at-bats. But he's behind 0-2 now to Cronin. Here's the pitch. Swinging a chopper right off the plate. Meadows is going to charge. His only play is going to be to first. And he fires it across for the second out. So two away. And here's Tyler Nordgren. Nordgren, 2-for-3 tonight. He has driven in a run. He has scored twice. Cronin, first pitch, and that's low, and it almost gets away from Kimbrell, but it's recovered quickly, and it's 1-0. There's a chance that she might have gotten crossed up a bit there. She was step on the inside corner, and that pitch kind of backed up on her a bit, but she was able to recover it after knocking it down. So 1-0 now to the DH for the Diamonds. The pitch, slider, right on the outside corner for strike one. Cronin with a nod of the head. And the 1-1. Slider, reach for and fouled off to the right, and it's 1-2. So Cronin a pitch away from getting out of it here. Cronin with the 1-2, and it's low, and it does get away from Kimbrell, and coming home will be Odo, and it's 13-0. No, got a tag right there coming home on that wild pitch. So 2-2 as Cronin tries to finish this inning off, and that is a sharp grounder to short. Meadows with a sliding stab behind the bag, and it's picked out by Baptista on the other end, and that ends the inning. Three very nice plays by Meadows at short, but the Diamonds score for the fourth straight inning. As we go to the bottom half of the fifth, it's 13-0 here, Pittsburgh over Sonoma.
We would like to thank our community partners, Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty, Myers Financial, Body Best Collision Center, Krista Granton Insurance, and Marbray Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice.
We're back here. Diamonds add another here in the top half of the fifth. It'll be Joel Carranza to lead things off for the Stompers. Or pardon me, Daniel Baptista to lead things off, and then Joel Carranza, and then Cody Bishop. So the Stompers right now, in the midst of a three-game skid coming into tonight's game, their longest losing streak of the year was three games. Suffered against a couple of teams, the Vallejo Admirals, and then into the San Rafael Pacific Series. But now the three-game losing streak coming into tonight's game, and now they're down big here tonight. Not the best start to the second half for this team that won the first half. They were in first place for basically all but 2 days, the first day of the season, and one time when they were a game back of San Rafael before the penultimate week of the first half began. And then the Stompers ran off 5 of 6 victories, while the Pacifics lost 5 of 6. The Stompers went out in front as the Diamonds continued to play good baseball. And then from there, the Diamonds and Stompers matched up in the final series of the first half. Sonoma came out victorious to win the first half for the second consecutive season. But this is a lull that the Stompers were hoping they wouldn't hit this early in the second half, especially with San Rafael playing their best baseball of the season and the Diamonds ramping things up on their end as well, as Baptista stands in and takes a first pitch fastball for a called strike. He's singled to left his first time up. The only hit of the game so far for Sonoma, as the 0-1 is taken again on the outside corner, and it's strike two. So we talked about how adjusting to that outside pitch in this league is the biggest developmental curve, is what can you do with that pitch when it's not where you want it on the inner half.
It's quite shocking, right?
Baptista got a pitch up his first time up and was able to go to left with it. And now 0-2, and that one's lifted foul and out of play. And we'll do it again. And you do. You see that, especially with a right-handed heavy league, very few left-handed pitchers. And so right-handed hitters will see a right-hander about 80 to 85% of the time in this league, which means the breaking ball off the plate away is a pitch they see very often. There's a changeup, a rare one there from Brammer that was offered at by Baptista, and it's the second strikeout of the game. So one out for Carranza. Carranza grounded into a 5-4-3 double play his last time up, as Holiday continues to warm down in the bullpen for Sonoma. There's the veteran Carranza waiting on the first pitch here from Brammer, and it's right there for a called strike. Brammer has taken control of this one after a little bit of a rough start, although he has definitely settled down. 0-1, and that cutter's outside for ball one. He threw a lot of pitches in that first inning, but still was three up, three down. And after having some early control issues, he's starting to have a better split between balls and strikes. Almost two-thirds. He is above 60% on his strike count. 1-1. And that fastball's at the knees for a called strike. 1-2. He's now at 68 pitches, and 44 of them have been strikes. Brammer, a nod of the head as he's ahead 1-2 to Carranza. And that one is off the fist and blooped into right center for a base hit. A little soft liner as Carranza gets aboard for the first time. Second hit of the game for Sonoma. And the Stompers with one out will have Cody Bishop come to the plate. Carranza has been mired in a little bit of a slump lately. Coming into this game, he was 1 for his last 12 and 3 for his last 21, although he had drawn 4 walks in that time frame. But his batting average, which at its high point this year was in the 340 range, as that pitch is a fastball in the outside corner for a called strike, has dipped down below the 300 mark. Bishop bounced out to first base his first time up. And the 0-1, swinging a bouncer right side. Kyriakos has it. He's going to go to second for one, on to first, and Bishop beats it out. So it'll be a fielder's choice, 4-6. And there's two out here as Anna Kimbrell will come to the plate. Kimbrell popped out to the pitcher her first time up. And she bats with Bishop at the plate. And the first pitch is taken all the way for a called strike. Kimbrell looking to get something going here with two outs. No batting gloves from the right side. 0-1, swinging a foul back, and it's nothing and two. Brammer trying to get out of this fifth. And the 0-2 is strike three called on the inside corner. And the inning is over. Third strikeout for Brammer. We'll go to the sixth. It's still 13-0 Pittsburgh here on SVTV. We'll be back.
Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small-town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
We're back, and we're going to have a couple of substitutions here, as Stacy Piagno is going to come in and play second base, which was her position in college, along with her being a pitcher, as Rawhide dances to the YMCA. You're also going to see Marcus Blackman come in to play first base, replacing Daniel Baptista. And so a couple of defensive changes here, and the new pitcher is going to be Jesse Holliday. So Holliday becomes the third pitcher of the night for Sonoma, the left-hander who pitched at Southern University, making his third appearance. And he has thrown one full inning. He had come in mainly as a situational lefty. He has allowed three base runners, allowed a homer, two strikeouts in that inning, with two earned runs allowed. He pitched at Southern University from 2010 through 2013 with current Dodgers top prospect Jose De Leon and former Stomper Santos Saldivar, who is playing in the Milwaukee Brewers organization. And it will be his third appearance, as you see the crowd here still into it, in a 13-0 game, as the Stompers have fallen behind in the second and have not been able to come up with anything offensively. And it will be Stacy Piagno at second base now, replacing Yuki Yasuda, and Marcus Blackman at first base, replacing Daniel Baptista. And so the Stompers in this loss or pardon me, this losing situation. Trying to give some time to some people. We talked about how in the bullpen some guys haven't thrown because they normally are in when the team is ahead. As Holiday's first pitch to Hagenmiller is high, ball one. Saldivar, the former teammate of Holiday, is now with Helena in the Northwest League. And that pitch in there for a strike, one and one. And that pitch is a slider in the dirt, 2-1. You can see kind of a funky delivery there by Holiday. No surprise he's wearing 35. Kind of patterns it after Dontrell Willis, although it's not as exaggerated with that leg kick. 2-1, and that's in the dirt. Gets by everybody for ball three. Three-one, and that's in the dirt, ball four. And so Holiday with a walk to lead things off here in the sixth. And it'll be Jordan Allen coming to the plate here with a runner at first. The Stompers as a team tonight have walked six hitters. And we're just beginning the sixth inning. A total of, 18 base runners allowed by Sonoma pitching tonight. Kelsie Whitmore began this game through a perfect first inning, but then ran into issues in the second as Holiday will step off out of the stretch. And I think he wants Blackman to hold him on even though there's a 13-0 lead. Yellen 0 for 2 with a sac fly. And that first pitch fastball is away for ball one. Four runs in the second for the Diamonds, all coming against Whitmore. As Holiday with the 1-0, and that cutter is there for a strike, 1-1. And then the first two got on, and Martin Cronin allowed the two inherited base runners to come in. And then from there, it was an offensive onslaught. Five in that third, three in the fourth, and then one again in the fifth. 1-1, and that almost gets by Kimbrell. It actually tips off her glove and hits the home plate umpire, and Hagenmiller will stay put. It's 2-1. So this game that, the fans give them all the credit in the world. They just love to see Piagno and Whitmore and Kimbrell get their shot. As the 2-1 from Holiday is lifted high in the air but out of play to the right, and it's 2-2. And we heard something there. That got something. That's a full parking lot. Right here in downtown Sonoma, and so the weekends are crazy during the summertime with a lot of tourists. Of course, it's wine country. But there's also weddings. There's a softball tournament going on this weekend, and that's across the street here. Kind of the main baseball facility in Sonoma, the Field of Dreams, 2-2. Swing and a miss. And Holiday with the strikeout there of Yallen, one gone. And so here is Starnes, who is 0-2 tonight with a walk and a couple of runs scored. And the first pitch is a cutter for a strike. Hagenmiller off at first, not being held on with a 13-0 lead. And that cutter's popped up. Shallow right field, Fox coming over, Blackman going out, and it'll be Blackman making the catch on the run over his shoulder. Nicely done. That's a catcher normally playing first base right there. And he's able to run that down in foul territory. Nice play. Two gone. And so here's Kiriakos with two out. Kiriakos in his fifth at bat already. He is 0 for 3 with a walk. He has flied out three times. First pitch is low, and it's blocked by Kimbrell for ball one. Holiday with the 1-0, and that is a bit down and in for ball two. Holiday. It's been a little bit wild this inning as that pitch is lifted high in the air to right center field. Fox is trying to track it down, and he'll square up and make the catch right in front of the 345 marker in right center field. So the leadoff walk by Holiday, but he gets a strikeout, a pop out, and a fly out to get out of things here in the sixth. The first scoreless inning for the Diamonds since Kelsie Whitmore's first inning way back in the first. Bottom six, Sonoma trailing 13-0 here on SVTV. We'll be back.
Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small-town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
There's Rawhide trying to get the crowd into it with this rally. It'll be Morlawera, then Piagno, who came in as a defensive replacement in the top half of the sixth for Yuki Yasuda, and then Chaz Meadows. So Brammer, who has been very good tonight, has allowed only three base runners in his five innings, three strikeouts. And it'll be Morlawera to lead things off for Sonoma, who trail big time here at home. 13-0 is the score. As Brammer has just been sensational tonight. It's been one of his best starts of the season. After this game, make sure to check out SportsCenter on ESPN. We're going to have both Kelsie Whitmore and Anna Kimbrell available to talk. We're actually just featured on SportsCenter a few minutes ago on the West Coast 11 p.m. version. So after the game, you know, closer probably to the 10 o'clock show, maybe the end of the 9 o'clock show out here on the West Coast, you'll have that feed as that pitch is high, ball one to Morlawera, who struck out looking on a fastball his first time up. Morlawera has to get something started here for the Stompers. Offensively, they've not had their best stuff going, as that is there for a strike, and it's 1-1. Brammer has thrown 51 of his 76 pitches for strikes. 1-1, swinging a pop-up. Shallow right field, going out Kiriakos, but it'll be called off here as Kelly Starn settles under it for the first out. And here's Stacy Piagno. So Piagno steps to the plate. As Brammer steps off. Piagno, 0-for-3 this year with a walk. And the first pitch is taken high for ball one. She's mostly pitched this year for the Stompers. Started at first base for a game, actually against the Diamonds last week, 1-0. Swing and a miss, and it's 1-1. One and one here. And the pitch, swing and a miss, and it's 1-2, just challenging her with the fastball. So Piagno has to time it out a little bit quicker. Brammer looking for his fourth strikeout, the 1-2, way up high, and it's 2-2. So 2-2. And the pitch on the way, and that's taken. Strike three. Piagno expecting the breaking ball. And Brammer blows one right by her. And that is at the fourth strikeout for Brammer, the second out. And it's two gone here for Chaz Meadows. Meadows has bounced out to third and popped out to second. Meadows, who's made some very nice plays at shortstop tonight, takes a fastball for a called strike. Oh and one, and the pitch, swinging a bouncer to short. To his counterpart, and it's bobbled by Scholl. And the air is going to allow Meadows to reach. So Scholl just can't handle that one. And it's two gone for Derek Fox. Fox at the belt. And the first pitch outside, ball one. Meadows. Not being held on over at first base, and why not in a 13-0 game. 1-0, and that's high ball two. Brammer has now thrown 86 pitches. 57 of them have been for strikes. Two and oh, and the pitch, and that fastball is on the outside corner for a strike. Fox today 0-for-2. He is flied out to center, grounded out to second. As Brammer, ready to throw his 88th pitch. And the 2-1, swinging a line in the left, going over Hagenmiller, and he makes the catch on the run, and that ends the inning. One left on for the Stompers after the air. We'll go to the seventh. It's Sonoma still trailing 13-0. We'll be back.
We would like to thank our community partners. Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty. Myers Financial. Body Best Collision Center. Krista Granton Insurance. And Marbre Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice.
We're back.
We're back here at Sonoma, leading or trailing 13-0. And it'll be Holiday in his second inning of work as he will face Scholl, Odo, and Taylor. 2-3-4. The Stompers will be back tomorrow here at People's Home Equity Ballpark on Saturday, July the 23rd. 5 p.m. will be the first pitch here. You can get your tickets online at stompersbaseball.com. As Sonoma will play game two of this three-game series against the Pittsburg Diamonds. Mike Jackson Jr., the probable starter, the son of former Major League reliever Mike Jackson. Spent 18 years in the majors. Of course, local fans remember him from his time with the Giants. He also pitched with the Indians, was in a couple World Series. Also with the Mariners at one point. Had 81 appearances in 1993, and I remember that 1993 season as Holiday. First pitch is bounced to third base. Morloera has it, and Scholl is out on one pitch here in the seventh. Of course, that was the year 1993, and the Giants won 103 games. That was the year before the strike in 94, and then, of course, after that, the split of the divisions into the West, Central, and East, as we've had them now for over 20 years. And was probably the last great quote-unquote pennant race in the old style, where there was the West and East divisions in each of the two leagues. And on the final day of the season, I believe it was John Smoltz for the Braves, throwing a complete game victory. Solomon Torres rolling over against the Dodgers as a slider swung on and missed there by Odo for strike one. So it will be Mike Jackson Jr. tomorrow, 5 p.m. He's thrown two consecutive nine-inning starts. One was a complete game. The other one went to the 10th inning. Needed only 99 pitches in the complete game victory last Sunday, or Saturday, against Vallejo, as that's fouled off to the left by Odo, nothing in two. Then on Sunday, it's the sidewinder Taylor Thurber who will throw for the Stompers, who's been very good since moving into the starting rotation. Juan Espinosa has gotten up for the Stompers in the bullpen. 0-2 is Holiday will step off here. Top seven. Stompers trail big 13-0. As the first two pitches from Holiday were in there, and that one's fouled off. We'll do it again. The Stompers, who won the first half, have kind of seen their tables turned a little bit in the beginning of this second half as the 0-2. Swing and a line shot right to Meadows at short. And the second out. Meadows, who's been very good basically all game long for the Stompers at shortstop, makes another nice play there. And with two gone, here's Taylor. Taylor has a homer in this game, his ninth of the season. That was against Whitmore to lead off the second. And the pitch, and a slider is high for ball one. He's now second in the league in homers behind Brent Gillespie of San Rafael, who has 12 on the season. 1-0, and that slider's in there for a strike, 1-1. He has now hit 33 homers the last two seasons with the Diamonds. And the 1-1 is in the dirt, blocked by Kimbrell, 2-1. His 24 homers last year were the second most in a single season in the Pacific Association's short history. Matt Chavez, who was with San Rafael last year, the unanimous MVP, had 31 and did it with 2 weeks left in the season before he was signed by the Padres, as that's a liner into center field for a base hit. Taylor has his third hit of the night. And he'll keep this inning going as Rich Mejia comes to the plate. He also has three hits. So Espinosa, we've mentioned, has really not had a lot of work these last couple of games with the Stompers on the losing end against the Pacifics this week coming in, and that slider is down for ball one. Mejia was retired for the first time on a nice play by Meadows in his last at bat, as Blackman, who chased one down earlier, is going to watch this go into the bullpen behind Espinosa, who was warming up, and it's 1-1. One and one now, as Holiday's pitch is taken at the knee as a slider for a called strike, and it's 1-2. And the pitch, slider, is chopped right up off a home plate and right to Holiday. He'll turn and fire, and the inning is over. So the single by Taylor is all that Holiday gives up. Two scoreless innings for the left-hander. We will head now to the bottom of the seventh. It's time to stretch here. And Aaron Miles out there thinking that that ball.
Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small-town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
We're back. You can see them still talking about that play. Aaron Miles asking Eric Thompson, the field umpire, did you not see that ball come up and hit Mejia? And instead, that is the end of the inning. But in a 13-0 game, Miles not really going to get into too much of an argument. His team has been in control basically since the second. It was a great start to this one as Kelsie Whitmore threw a perfect first inning, but then Mike Taylor led off the second with a homer, and things started to unravel a bit for the 18-year-old who made her pitching debut tonight. But she has quite a future ahead of her. We talked about her scholarship to Cal State Fullerton, and then along with that, she will be joining her fellow Stomper teammates tonight, Stacy Piagno and Anna Kimbrell, in South Korea in September for the U.S. Women's World Cup of Baseball. It will be for Kimbrell her fifth trip internationally to the Women's World Cup. For Piagno, it will be her third, and for Whitmore, her second. And both Piagno and Whitmore expected to pitch. Whitmore will play as well defensively. Piagno might also play a little bit at second base, maybe even third base. And it will be Kimbrell, the main catcher for this team. And so they will be preparing for that here in a couple of weeks. We talked about how Whitmore will be with the team only until the end of next week, and then she will have some softball-related things to take care of with Fullerton before she returns for a weekend in mid-August. Piagno will be with her with the team until she reports for the U.S. Women's National Team. As a first-pitch fastball at the knees for a called strike, it's nothing in one. To Caleb Bryson, who has walked and grounded out sharply to short. Kimbrell will be here only for a few days. And this is one of the things with this venture, as that's a pitch high ball one. You know, trying to get this with all these schedules involved. These summers weren't open for these women that the Stompers had scouted over the last few months. A nine-month process as Bryson fouls this one off to the right, and it's 1-2. And so Kimbrell, who the Stompers had seen at a U.S. women's tryout in North Carolina back in June, along with Piagno and Whitmore. They had already talked with Piagno and Whitmore before then as far as the idea of them coming to play for the Stompers was concerned, and that's a spike of a pitch by Brammer that gets to the backstop, 2-2. But, you know, we talked about with Whitmore having her college stuff starting up, and then Piagno, who is actually getting her teacher credential, she's going to get that started in the fall. She will be away for the Women's World Cup, of course. And Kimbrell, who works down in her home state of, or pardon me, in Alabama. She's originally from South Carolina. As the 2-2, and that's high ball three. And so they all have these different things they're doing. And Kimbrell will be with the team through next Tuesday. And then from there, it'll be a couple of weeks left with the women before they head off to the next step for all of them. 3-2, swinging a pop-up. Bryson towards the right side as Taylor will settle under it and make the catch right behind the bag for the first out. Here's Marcus Blackman. Blackman entered as a defensive replacement in the sixth. The backup catcher also playing first. Blackman has had his struggles at the plate this year, and he takes a first pitch fastball for a strike. He is 6 of 33, and he has struck out 17 times out of the 27 outs he's recorded. Went 0 for 1 last night with a strikeout and a pinch hitting appearance. 0-1, high ball one. Whitmore is going to be the perhaps one of the more interesting cases going forward, because as she goes to Fullerton, her scholarship is in softball, but she is going to be allowed to work out with the men's baseball team. As the 1-1, swung on and missed on a slider, 1-2. And so she'll get to do both. And she intends to keep playing baseball as long as she can. She has been playing it since she was 6 years old. And she is truly a prodigy. She's already at 18 years old, one of the best female players in the country. As that's a swing and a miss by Blackman. And he goes down for the second out of this seventh inning. So here's Carranza. He's 1-for-2, single to right center his last time up, breaking a 1-for-13 skid, also a 3-for-22 skid. The veteran power hitting right-handed hitter, and swings and fouls one back, and again we have lost our camera behind home plate. Well, that happens. We have it all set up. It's braced and everything, and then all of a sudden, this one foul ball sets it off. It's taken a beating these last couple of nights. 0-1, and the pitch is down, ball one. So began this story with the women playing for the Stompers back on July the 1st when Piagno pitched and Whitmore started and left. As the 1-1, swing and a miss on a cutter, it's 1-2. Whitmore then had some family obligations that she had already set up before she agreed to this, and part of it was her graduation and some stuff like that, and So she's left the team for about a week and a half before coming back earlier this week as Carranza lifts one high in the air to shallow right center. And coming on will be Yellen, and he'll make the catch, and the inning is over. Brammer just continues to roll here. He has faced only three over the minimum through seven. We'll go to the eighth. It's still 13-0 Pittsburgh here at People's Home Equity Ballpark. We'll be back.
Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small-town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
We're back here, top eighth, and the new pitcher for the Stompers is the right-hander Juan Espinosa, making his fourth appearance. The Miami, Florida native, he was born in Cuba and moved to the United States with his family when he was 4 years old. He's pitched at Northwestern Ohio in his college days, and this year he has been a tremendous add for the Stompers out of the bullpen. This will be his 13th appearance. He has struck out 29 in 25 innings, 2-1 with a 2.52 earned run average with three saves, and all of them have been of the three-inning variety. 23 hits, only seven walks. And the right-hander, who features a four-pitch mix where he can do multiple things with the fastball. He'll throw a slider. That's his main 1-2 combo. There's Anna Kimbrell in there for her eighth inning of work. And he'll also throw a curveball and a changeup from time to time, but he has been stellar. And we mentioned how he's been the relief ace. He's really only come into games when it's been close or the Stompers have been ahead. But unfortunately for Espinosa, that hasn't been the case all week. And the two games before this week began, both starters, Mike Jackson this past Saturday, and then Taylor Thurber this past Sunday, both threw complete games. And so it's been a week since Espinosa's been out there. This is his first appearance for the Stompers since July the 9th, so almost 2 weeks for him. And he's happy to get into this game, even if it is in mop-up work. And that breaking ball, a good one, drops in there for a called strike to Tyler Nordgren, who is 2-for-4 tonight. Espinosa rocks and fires, and a changeup swung on and missed there. It's nothing in two. Still trying to get the back camera going. We mentioned how we've had some issues with it, so we apologize. You're getting some wide shots here. Espinosa ready to go here with the 0-2 pitch. Slider fouled back by Nordgren. So 5 p.m. tomorrow, we'll be on the radio. It'll be Jeff Safford on the call. You can pick that up on TuneIn, on your mobile devices, and also on StompersBaseball.com just by clicking the Listen Live link as the 0-2 is fouled right back. And Nordgren, as we were just about ready to get our camera set, and, of course, that foul back almost made us have to reset the process. So 0-2. Slider foul back again. And so Nordgren just fighting off pitch after pitch here from Espinosa. Nordgren waiting on the 0-2. And that's a bouncer to the right side. Lined in the right field for a base hit. As Nordgren is aboard with his third hit. He's the third player with at least three hits for the Diamonds tonight. As Ian Hagemiller comes to the plate, 2-for-2 with a couple of doubles and a couple of walks. He has scored twice and driven in a run. That's now 13 hits for the Diamonds as the first pitch changeup is swung on and missed. And it's nothing in one. We talked about how hot Norgren has been. Hitting 360 coming into the game. He adds three hits tonight, and that slider misses low for ball one. I don't know what happened there. The pitch looked like it had plenty of times. We have our rear camera back. 1-1, swinging a foul back, and it's 1-2. Hagen Miller had really struggled coming into this game, then all of a sudden found his stroke. He had only seven hits in his 44 at-bats coming in. He's been on base all four times tonight. Former Braves minor leaguer, and that slider is called strike three, and he did not see that one from Espinosa, and there's the first strikeout for the right-hander, and the first time that Hagen Miller has been retired tonight as Jordan Yellen comes to the plate. One of the rare hitters in this lineup without a time on base by a hit or a walk. He has reached twice on a fielder's choice. He's also got a sac fly, two driven in. First pitch, slider is a bit outside for ball one. Espy is his teammates call him for short. One of the more obvious nicknames is that fastball is on the outside corner for a called strike, and it's 1-1. It's Jordan Yellen. 1-1. As the pitch and the breaking ball missing outside, 2-1. Fans wanted that one. Reminder again that you want to tune into SportsCenter after this game on ESPN, as both Kelsie Whitmore and Anna Kimbrell will be on the show, as that one's fouled off the foot of Yellen, and it's now 2-2. And he's going to have to walk that one off, as you can see. Saw that play earlier with Mejia where it looked like he might have fouled it off of his foot, but it was instead fielded by Holiday, and he threw him out. But that one definitely hit Yellen, and he's in pain, but he'll have to stay in there on this 2-2 count. Diamonds have led basically all the way. They got four in the second and haven't looked back. And it's been Dylan Brammer on the other side pitching a gem for the Diamonds. The 2-2, and that's inside for ball three. So Espinosa in a 13-0 game, 3-2. You got to throw a strike here. No need to be fine. Make him beat you. And 3-2, and a slider is up and in, ball four. And so a walk here for Espinosa. And here comes Kelly Starnes. He has walked. He's also driven in a run via an RBI ground out to short. He's also scored two times, having reached on a fielder's choice. First pitch, slider in there for a called strike. Espinosa setting high. The 0-1 and a changeup there for a strike, and it's nothing and two. And this is what Espinosa needs to do here. You're down 13 runs. You just need to throw some strikes. And that's a fastball. Strike three called on the outside. Even if Starnes didn't go around, that was a strikeout all the way. And it's the second one of the inning for Espinosa, as Kiriakos will step up 0-for-4 with a walk. First pitch, and a changeup drifts inside. Stompers play their next five at home. Longest homestand of the season, 1-0, and the breaking ball is off the plate for ball two. And they'll be looking to bounce back tomorrow. They'd love to get a rally going. They have six outs to go, 2-0. Swing and a miss through a changeup with Carriaco sitting fastball, 2-1. Very good pitch, as good as Espinosa's breaking balls are. That changeup can really fool even right-handed hitters. 2-1, slider, and it's a strike on the outside. Espinosa off the third base side. And the 2-2. Slider swung on and missed. And Espinosa strikes out the side here in the eighth. Two runners left on for the Diamonds. We'll go to the bottom half. Still 13-0 Pittsburgh here on SVTV.
We would like to thank our community partners. Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty. Myers Financial. Body Best Collision Center. Krista Granton Insurance. And Marbre Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice.
Top eight, there's Jose Flores, who is going to get an inning here in the ninth, and he's hearing if he needs to get going now or if he's going to really need to ramp up, to begin the ninth inning. And we talked about how Flores and Espinosa hadn't really seen much time in the last week or so. For Espinosa, it had been almost 2 weeks. Same thing with Flores. Flores was a starter to begin the season before he got moved to the closer's role. One of the hardest throwers in this league, if not the hardest. Has topped out at 95 miles an hour. The former Brewers farmhand, as Cody Bishop stands in to begin the bottom half of this eighth inning. It'll be Bishop, Kimbrell, and then Moraloera. Bishop batting from the left side tonight, 0-2. And he takes a fastball outside from Brammer for ball one. Brammer, seven innings, two hits, one walk, five strikeouts. A brilliant performance. He's thrown 68 of 103 pitches for strikes. 1-0, and that's low ball two to Bishop. Bottom of the order for Sonoma here in the eighth, as they have trailed since the second. All 13 runs coming in the second through fifth innings. 2-0 on the way, and that's taken at the knees for a called strike. Brammer trying to battle back here against Bishop. And he throws another one on the outside corner, and it's 2-2. Brammer. With a long pause there. And the 2-2, and that's swung on and fouled back by Bishop. We'll do it again. There is some action down in the bullpen for the Diamonds. That looks like, I was going to say that was Joe Mello, but that instead looks like it's Justin Lawrence for Pittsburgh. Brammer with the 2-2. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball by him. That's the sixth strikeout of the night for Brammer, and here comes Anna Kimbrell to the plate. Kimbrell 0-2 tonight. She popped out to the pitcher and then struck out looking against Brammer back in the fifth. First pitch, and that's down and in, ball one. Kimbrell making her debut tonight with the Stompers. 1-0. Swinging a ball lifted high in the air to center, but this will be playable for Yallen, who settles under it and makes the catch for the second out. So here's Moore Loera. Moore Loera got caught looking on a fastball in the outside corner in the third, and then flew out to shallow right center in the sixth. First pitch, and that's there for a strike. Brammer trying to close out his eighth inning, which will most likely be his last. 0-1. Swinging a ball at the end of the bat towards second. Backhanded by Kyriakos in the grass, and he throws him out to end the inning. Eight shutout innings by Dylan Brammer. One of his best as a Diamond in his three seasons here. We'll be back with the ninth here, 13-0 on SVTV.
Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small-town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
So top nine, and Jose Flores will get the start. Or begin the ninth inning. Flores, who we mentioned, has been moved to the closer's role after a rough beginning as a starter. The right-hander is in his ninth appearance, 33 innings, 33 strikeouts, 2-2 with a 5.45 earned run average. He walked 23 batters, allowed 32 hits. But since moving to the bullpen, he's allowed only one earned run in three innings, four hits, has struck out four with nobody walked. And he throws a fastball that will touch 95 miles an hour with a good slider and a big curveball. And it'll be his job in this one, as we're having issues with the camera behind home plate, to face 2-3-4, Thomas Scholl, Nick Godo, and Mike Taylor. So a good challenge here for Flores as the Stompers trailing 13-0. It seems we're getting all types of feedback here on our video, unfortunately, all over the place. So we apologize for that there at home, as Scholl steps up to the plate for the sixth time tonight. He is one for four with a walk and three driven in. And he'll face Flores here to begin this ninth. Flores, the first pitch, and it's a fastball away for ball one. Might be my monitor, too. I hope you're not seeing that at home. 1-0 from Flores. It's high, ball two. Flores, out of the University of Arts and Sciences in Oklahoma, signed by the Brewers last year. takes his customary deep breath, and then the 2-0. And that is inside ball three. Actually hit the umpire on his shin guard there. As Scholl has had some relatively easy takes. Flores with the 3-0 offering on the way. And that's a strike at the belt. It's 3-1. Flores has to battle all the way back here. And that's there on the outside corner for a called strike. And it's 3-2. Swing and a foul back, and we'll do it again. Flores with that good fastball trying to retire Scholl. And that slider in the dirt is spiked. And it's a walk by Scholl to lead off this ninth inning. And we have a pinch hitter here. And Dylan Brammer is going to hit for himself here. So Brammer will get a chance to hit here. And that pitch is there for a strike. So they're going to lose the DH. As the strike there, and that's bounced towards first, and Blackman can't handle it, and everybody's going to be safe on the air. So the air by Blackman, and now Taylor will come to the plate. As the first pitch here to Taylor is in the dirt, blocked by Kimbrell for ball one. Taylor has had a three-hit night, including his ninth homer back in the second. That was the first run of this ball game, a solo shot against Kelsie Whitmore, who went two-plus innings. Flores with the 1-0, swing and a miss, blew the fastball by him. It's 1-1. Flores walking Scholl, and then the ground ball to first that Blackman couldn't handle. And the 1-1. And a fastball just off the plate away. It's 2-1. And that swung on and missed. And it's 2-2 now. And so Flores just trying to blow Taylor away here. Just bring in the cheddar. The 2-2. Swing and a miss. Does it again. And with three straight fastballs after getting behind 2-0, he retires Taylor on strikes. And here comes Rich Mejia. 3-for-5, although he's been retired in his last two at-bats. First pitch, swing and a pop-up. Blackman will give chase, but it's out of play. And it's nothing in one. So Schultz second and at first base in this one. Reaching on the air, Dylan Brammer, 0-1. In the dirt, blocked well by Kimbrell, and it's 1-1. So the Stompers have not led in this game. at all. It's been all diamonds since the second. Kind of spoiling the party here tonight. 1-1. Swinging a bouncer towards short, could be two. Meadows has it, will flip to second for one, and Piagno's pulled off the bag again on an errant throw by Meadows. Second time tonight he's done that, and two errors behind Flores in this game, pardon me, in this inning. And what should have been the third out there will keep it going for Tyler Norgren. First pitch, swung on and missed as Norgren chased a pitch up. Time called as Flores came set just as Norgren stepped into the box. The 0-1, swing and a miss, chased another fastball up, and it's 1-2, or nothing and two. That's at 94 miles an hour on that pitch. 0-2 here from Flores. And the pitch. Swing and a miss. Just decided to blow up by him again. And that's the second strikeout. Flores had gotten a couple of ground balls, but at this point he's just saying, I'll just do it myself at this point. As Hagen Miller, who's 2-for-3 tonight, steps up to the plate. He struck out looking against Espinosa. His last time up. Only time he's been retired today. First pitch, swung on and miss. As Flores just continues to blow the fastball by these Diamonds hitters. Flores, the 0-1, up and in for ball one. It's calm down here at People's Home Equity Ballpark. Into a nice evening here in beautiful Sonoma Valley. 1-1, swung on and fouled right back up off of Kimbrell's mask. And it's 1-2. She's okay. Flores, who has struck out two in this inning, two errors behind him, but trying to put this game away, or put the inning away, I should say. And the pitch is off the end of the bat towards first, and a broken bat for Hagen Miller on that slider, and we'll do it again. And Hagen Miller pointing out the bat he wants. Hagen Miller. Steps back in with the new piece as Flores sets. 1-2. Fastball. Strike three called on the inside corner. And striking out the side is Flores after two errors behind him to get out of the top of the ninth. Bottom half of the ninth. Sonoma will need a couple of touchdowns here. It's 13-0 on SVTV.
We would like to thank our community partners, Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty, Myers Financial, Body Best Collision Center, Krista Granton Insurance, and Marbre Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice.
We're back. They just introduced Tamara Holmes, who's going to be the captain of Team USA when the women's national team travels to South Korea in September for the Women's World Cup. And we have a new pitcher on for the Diamonds as Aldo Ferrante will come in. He's actually batting third in this lineup as Nordgren will move behind the plate. And so that's the switch where they lose the DH. Ferrante will face Stacy Piagno, Chaz Meadows, and Derek Fox at the top of this order. Ferrante, who just got reactivated by the Diamonds before this series, has very good stuff, but it's just all over the place. He's walked four, allowed three hits, seven earned runs in his two innings, and a lot of those have been inherited. But he's got a big hook, as you just saw there, and a fastball that'll sit in the lower 90s, and so this will be the last stand for the Stompers, who trail 13-0 on this night where it was the first time since the All-American Girls Professional Baseball League that a woman pitcher and woman catcher were on the field together. And it's the first time in a men's professional league that that's ever happened. And it will be Stacy Piagno coming to the plate here in her second at bat. She struck out looking against Brammer back in her first at bat in the sixth. And the first pitch to Piagno is a strike at the knees. Piagno, who entered in the sixth inning as a defensive replacement for Yuki Yasuda at second, waits on the 0-1 and fouls one off to the right, and it's nothing at two. Ferrante, big guy, 6'3", 220 pounds. Coming set, and the pitch, and that's inside, ball one. Piagno, getting her second at bat. Behind one and two now to Ferrante. And the pitch, swinging a ball off the fist towards second. Coming in Kyriakos, and he can't handle it. And that's going to be a hit. Tough play there for Kyriakos with some English. And that is going to be a hit for Stacy Piagno. And so Piagno, just like Kelsie Whitmore this past Wednesday, picks up her first professional hit. Got jammed there, but got enough to kind of bloop it in front for an infield single. And a nice round of applause here as it's announced that it's Piagno's first professional hit. And so the Stompers have the leadoff woman aboard here with Chaz Meadows at the plate. And that fastball is inside, ball one. Ferrante doesn't have to worry about Piagno stealing it first, not being held on in a 13-0 game. 1-0, and that's low, ball two. Meadows waiting, and the 2-0. And that's there for a strike. 2-1. To Meadows. Swinging a high fly ball down the left field line. Mejia giving chase. So is Scholl. And this one will fall just beyond the fence line. into the Werowoco Moco Club. 2-2. That's the club sponsored by Virginia Dare Winery, Sonoma's premier partners for 2016. And the pitch on the way here from Aldo Ferrante, the 2-2, and that slider missing high for ball three. And it's a full count. Three, two. Swing and a miss. Meadows chased a pitch at his eyes. And there's the first strikeout. At 95 miles an hour. First pitch to Derek Fox, and that's a fastball in the outside corner for a called strike. On one here to Fox, and the pitch is lifted in the air but out of play to the left. And it's 0-2. So Piagno picks up her first hit. In this inning, she's at first. 0-2 now to Derek Fox, and the pitch is low, ball one. So Ferrante bringing the heat here in the ninth. Each team throwing their hardest pitchers out there. As Fox stands in. And the 1-2, breaking ball, strike three called, and that's a beauty. Fox frozen there for the second out. Both strikeouts here, and the last gasp for the Stompers is Caleb Bryson. First pitch here to Bryson, who's 0-2 with a walk. And he takes down and away, ball one. Ferrante with a couple of strikeouts here. Jammed Piagno with the pitch up and in, but she was able to fight it off. And a ball with some English blooped over the mound. Kiriakos couldn't handle it, and it was a base hit. 1-0. And that's in the dirt, and that's going to get by, and Piagno will take second on the wild pitch. And this is the first time that the Stompers have had a runner in scoring position since the second inning. It has been a barren night offensively for Sonoma. Just only four base runners. They got on once via the air. Pardon me, five base runners if you want to count that, but four that will go in the book. As a 2-0 to Bryson, up an in ball three as he has to turn his head. That pitch that Piagno hit was a 92-mile-an-hour fastball up on the hands. The 3-0, and that is low ball four. So Bryson will take his second walk of the night. And here's Marcus Blackman. Blackman struck out swinging his first time up. And the pitch is right down Broadway for a strike. So if Pittsburgh hangs on, they're going to move to 5-2 in the second half. The Stompers would fall to 2-5. And in the other game going on in the Pacific Association, as that swung on and missed, 0-2. It's a 3-3 ball game in San Rafael between the Admirals and the Pacifics. And so Blackman down 0-2 here against Ferrante. As he sets high. And the pitch is right down the middle, strike three. And Blackman, expecting the breaking ball, goes down looking, and that ends the game. The party crashed by the Diamonds as the Stompers, with the first all-female battery in men's professional baseball, come in and just steamroll the Stompers. 13-0 the final score, and Sonoma will now try and bounce back tomorrow in game two of this series with Mike Jackson Jr. on the hill. We'll take a break and be back to wrap this up after this.
We would like to thank our community partners. Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com.
Here's the Stompers fall 13-0, and you know, it started out as one of those nights where the Stompers were celebrating the advancement of women in baseball, and Kelsie Whitmore went out there, threw a phenomenal first inning, 9 pitches, got out of there. But the second inning came around, and the Diamonds just turned this game on its head. The homer by Mike Taylor, and then 3 more runs, and the Stompers saw this game get out of control relatively quickly, and 13 runs in only 4 innings from the second through fifth for the Diamonds turned this into a 13-0 laugher. Now the Stompers 2-5 on the second half part of the schedule, and now they'll have to bounce back tomorrow with Mike Jackson Jr. on the hill. Stacy Piagno did get her first professional base hit with an infield single here in the ninth. But that's one of the only highlights here that the Stompers have outside of the good start to this game before it all came apart in the second. And so Sonoma, after a game like this, they've lost 4 straight now. There's really not much else they can do. They got to move forward and figure something out. And Mike Jackson, who's pitched very well in his last 2 starts, will get an opportunity to put the team on his back and get them a win tomorrow. Dylan Brammer, on the other hand, was just phenomenal tonight. He struck out 6 in 8 innings, allowed only 3 base runners, and he really just pounded the Stompers with fastballs to the point where they just could not keep up, and it turned into a pretty big loss here for Sonoma as they fall 13-0. Stay tuned on ESPN here. Relatively shortly, you will hear from both Kelsie Whitmore and Anna Kimbrell about tonight on the Sports Center, and so tune in there. Make sure that you get a chance to see that, as they were able to show some highlights from the game earlier tonight on a Sports Center. So really appreciate everybody tuning in on social media as well tonight, as the Stompers fall by the final score of 13-0. So Sonoma, with the loss tonight, they're 4th straight, and they'll bounce back tomorrow. 5 p.m. we'll be on the radio side with Jeff Safford at 4:50 on the Stompers Radio Network, online stompersbaseball.com, or via the TuneIn app. The Stompers in 2016, their premier partner is Virginia Dare Winery, the latest production by Francis Ford Coppola, as they try to be the pioneers in advancing women in professional baseball. The Stompers fall tonight, though, by the score of 13-0. So we're back at it tomorrow. Thanks for tuning in tonight, and we'll see you back here in Sonoma for game 2 of this 3-game series. Until then, good night, everybody.
Sonoma Stompers Baseball is brought to you in part by Broadway Market, a small town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com. Sonoma Materials, located at 21040 Broadway. For more information, you can go to sonomamaterials.com. Rugworks, located at 18700 Sonoma Highway. For more information, you can go to rugworks.com. We would like to thank our community partners: Tina Schoen, Broker Associates, Sotheby's International Realty, Myers Financial, Body Best Collision Center, Krista Granton Insurance, and Marbre Automotive. Social media support is provided by WordMice.